be a lot of weather going on up that direction. We're going to end up probably with some moisture, but it could be even rain showers on Christmas Eve. And this pattern continues after Christmas. A lot of digging of this big trough in the Pacific Northwest. So if you want to find a stormy location, it's going to be that direction. And then what we're going to see is these little pieces that break off, come our direction. They'll probably fluctuate our temperatures a little bit. But then after Christmas, there should be some colder air. Again, I'll hold back my thoughts on that for today. And we'll kind of let that sift and kind of cook another day on these temperatures as we get a better idea on how fast that's going to come south. We'll wrap up with the numbers here. Sioux Falls today, 25. That's colder than yesterday. And the forecast, when you look at the averages, above normal. I mean, even 38 on Wednesday is above the averages. 45 is definitely above normal on Thursday. Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, I'm more inclined to go upper 30s. A little moisture on Friday, but it's going to be hard to keep that all snow chances. I think a lot of it actually could be light showers. So it's probable right now that we'll stay above averages. And we'll see where Aberdeen fits into that. 30s for highs going into the weekend. Pierre's probably likely to be warmer on average compared to Sioux Falls and Aberdeen and even for Rapid City. Look at the 50s coming back on Wednesday and Thursday of this week. Forecast First is next.
When winter brings its worst, we bring you the best. Kelloland Live Doppler HD, where technology counts.
The snowfall amounts of a foot to maybe a foot and a half or more.
Experience matters.
A strong low-pressure system sitting and spinning right over us.
And trust is earned.
Still looking at around 6 to 12 inches of snow.
Only one weather team delivers season after season. Kelloland Live Doppler HD, the new generation of storm tracking.
Good morning, Kelloland Forecast First today. Well, cooler weather for most of us, 25 degrees in Sioux Falls this afternoon. North winds to go with that. Aberdeen, 17. Pier, mid-20s. Rapid City, a lot colder than yesterday. About 20 degrees, actually, cooler, and a high near 30. What does the rest of the weather look like heading into Christmas? Well, a lot to say about that, and we'll do that in this half hour of Kelloland This Morning.
Live from Kelloland Media Group, Kelloland This Morning.
A fire at a lodge in the Black Hills injures two firefighters. We have the details straight ahead.
Plus, what policies Congress will be considering next year to decriminalize marijuana. Coming up.
Good morning. Welcome to Kelloland This Morning. I'm Sarah McDonald.
And I'm Travis Fossing. After recent snowstorms across Kelloland, many people headed to the store for shovels and snowblowers.
Another item you might want to stock up on, ice melt. Kelloland's Ariana Schumacher went to Ace Hardware to learn more about the products offered. Good morning, Ariana.
Good morning. There are many different types of ice melt depending on your needs, such as pet-friendly, concrete-safe, and organic to protect your plants. But it can be hard to figure out exactly when to apply the ice melt to the sidewalks.
Really, I don't know that the time frame matters as much as what's going on with the weather. If it is currently like snowing and sleeting, you might want to wait until it's done. Unless it's going to be all day, then you might want to apply a couple times during the day.
When spreading the ice melt on your sidewalks, you want to make sure you're applying an even layer and not just putting it all in one spot, as this can cause damage to the concrete. Coming up in the next half hour of Kelloland This Morning, I'll show you a different application methods for the ice melt.
Thanks, Ariana. Well, turning to weather, we're making ice this morning, but temperatures are expected to warm throughout the week, Brian.
Yes, indeed. Yeah, we'll be melting more of that ice and snow, I think, as time goes on. But in the short run, we do have a little bit of snow falling right now. Let's have a look at that on Kelloland Live Doppler HD. And you notice the highlighted areas there running from Faith to Mobridge over to Aberdeen. Now, I would categorize this as very light snow. Flurries might be a better way to put that. If you want to look at what we have in Mulbridge, for example, out of that this morning, well, it looks like this. Just a little bit of a light coating of snow on some of those parking lots, but even onto the highways, a lot of it kind of blows off to the side of the road as temperatures are well below freezing. In fact, 17 is our morning start there in Mulbridge. Sioux Falls now 23. We are going to slip a little more yet this morning and then try to come back a little bit. The winds will add to this map today. -4 is our wind chill now in Watertown, 4 degrees in Brookings, and there's the wind. It's a steady breeze out of the north at 10 to 20 and a bit higher in spots like Pier. Highs today, there they are, all those 20s out there, even teens across the northeast. That's a quick look at weather, and we'll have the complete Christmas week forecast in just a few minutes.
Thank you, Brian. This morning, authorities in the Black Hills are trying to figure out what sparked a fire at a popular destination in Custer State Park. Crews from several agencies were called to Sylvan Lake Lodge Saturday night to put out the fire. Authorities remained at the scene through Sunday morning. Two firefighters were injured. However, none of the people at the lodge were hurt. Crews say the freezing temperatures, along with the snow and ice on the roads, made fighting the fire effort difficult.
Rapid City Police are asking people to come forward with information about a weekend shooting that sent a person to the hospital. Officers arrested 29-year-old Isaiah Mercado for aggravated assault in connection with a shooting early Saturday morning in downtown Rapid City. The victim was taken to the hospital, but they are expected to survive. Police say the shooting appears to be the result of a fight between two people who knew one another. If you have information about the incident, you're asked to call Rapid City Police. Authorities in Minnesota are investigating the deaths of 7 people inside a twin home in Moorhead. Police say the victims include 4 adults and 3 children. Family members found them Saturday night as they were conducting a welfare check and called police. Investigators say there were no signs of violence or forced entry. Police say they are not actively seeking any suspects. The bodies were taken to the Ramsey County Medical Examiner's Office in St. Paul for autopsies.
The trial for the former Minnesota officer who shot and killed Dante Wright will soon be in the hands of the jury. Closing arguments will start today in the manslaughter trial of Kim Potter, who says she meant to use her taser instead of her gun when she killed Wright as he tried to drive away from a traffic stop. The judge says she won't make any jurors deliberate on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. They'll return after the holiday if they haven't reached a verdict by then. The defense rested Friday after Potter testified that she didn't want to hurt anybody and that she was sorry it happened.
The president of Planned Parenthood's affiliate in the Upper Midwest says she is stepping down from her position next year. Sarah Stays oversaw the organization for nearly 20 years. She grew it into one of the largest Planned Parenthood affiliates in the country as it expanded from Minnesota and South Dakota to incorporate North Dakota, Iowa, and Nebraska. The 5-state organization provides health care to more than 100,000 patients each year. Stays does not plan to step down until October while the organization searches for her replacement. It's an issue advocates say is often overlooked, Indigenous women going missing or being murdered at higher rates than their white counterparts. Tribal members in Arizona and filmmakers are trying to change that. They're sharing a documentary called Somebody's Daughter to help raise awareness and get lawmakers' attention. According to the Justice Department, 4 out of 5 Native women are affected by violence in their lifetimes.
Congressional Democrats are gearing up for a sweeping set of initiatives aimed at decriminalizing marijuana. The legislation would include banking services for the nearly $18 billion industry and purge the criminal records of thousands of marijuana offenders. Nearly 70% of Americans, including roughly half of Republicans, support legalizing marijuana. This past year, more states legalized medical and recreational marijuana. Lawmakers plan to start debating the bills in the spring.
Schools are turning to educational programs based on cognitive behavior therapy to help children stay in school and learn. As part of this method, students at every grade level are taught how thoughts, feelings, and behaviors are linked. They learn how to control and reframe thoughts, which in turn can lead to more positive outcomes. Educators say many kids are still reeling from the pandemic and can't learn if they are struggling emotionally.
It's now 8 minutes after the hour, and still to come in this half hour of Kelloland This Morning, Brian tells us about the warm-up in advance of Christmas, plus the beauty of South Dakota's winters, featured on national television. That's ahead on Kelloland This Morning.
Kelloland Live Doppler HD, sponsored by First International Bank and Trust. Wishing all our customers and friends the best of the season. Discover the meaning of live first in the new year.
Welcome back. The snowfall in South Dakota was featured on this week's CBS Sunday Morning Show.
Kelloland's chief photographer, Kevin Kiergaard, shot video of the recent snowfall for the program's Do Nothing for 2 Minutes segment. This isn't the first time Kevin's work has been featured on the show.
His videos of the Badlands, the Black Hills Wild Horse Sanctuary, and the Greater Prairie Chickens of South Dakota have also been shown on CBS Sunday Morning.
Kevin never fails to deliver.
I know, and he always manages to capture wildlife. Look at those deer go. So.
Yeah, I was enjoying a cup of coffee yesterday morning and saw this. And yeah, a lot of deer made it on early in the segment. So yeah, just beautiful scenery.
Definitely. I don't know if we'll be seeing any of that. Any of that snow again anytime soon, Brian.
Yeah, a little here and there, but you know, a wide variety. Don't we have that here in Kelloland? And I always love those segments, you know, just a little nature, a little relaxation there. And yeah, it looks peaceful. Today, I imagine, more of those snowflakes. Well, a couple of them in the air and then more of them melting as the week goes on. This is the landscape that we have on the maps this morning. And as you look at the, well, where we still have snow on the ground, you know, we always bring up before Christmas, what are the odds of a white Christmas? I think Scott did that story last week again, just to refresh your memory. And I think in Sioux Falls, that's close to, on average, about 60%, give or take a little bit, that, you know, odds are in favor that we would have a white Christmas. And, you know, as of this morning, we still have a little bit on the ground. However, through the week, we're going to be fighting a battle of warmer temperatures and things that aren't probably as friendly toward that. More in a moment. Let's first bring up this, speaking of a variety of beautiful pictures in Kelloland. Mitchell at the Corn Palace, and boy, they are very festive there, aren't they? With wonderful lights. We've seen that Christmas tree, you know, from time to time when we've had the snow. It's been coated, and then it melts, and then the wind comes up. We've had all sorts of things this last couple of weeks. Today, probably more flurries than anything else, but fast-moving little patch of light returns on radar. Where are we talking? Well, Aberdeen's on the list there. Gettysburg down to about Faith and Eagle Butte, Dupree, just a bit of light snow. Nothing here to really cause any concerns or advisories or anything like that. It is, though, trending a little colder. We have teens in the north, 20s in the south, which you think about it, yeah, it's cooler than yesterday in our forecast, but still for December. I'm not going to say a whole lot about this because really we all know or should know by now how cold it can get this time of year. And I think we're avoiding that for now. So a little chilly, -4 is your wind chill value there in Watertown and 11 in Sioux Falls. So that's kind of the trajectory of our temperatures today. A little colder, the hourly numbers with the wind out of the north. I think we'll fall in Sioux Falls through the teens. We'll try to come back to the low 20s. I think Watertown and Aberdeen will sit in the mid-teens here this afternoon. And a few 20s in western South Dakota. Those highs technically close to 30 in Rapid City. Now tonight, a switch around on the wind, a little breeze out of the south. That's going to come in advance of this next, I would say it's kind of a clipper-like system, but it's just more or less a small low-pressure area that'll give a little snow to North Dakota. There it goes, skimming the north tomorrow morning in a very fast mover. So it's in and out of the picture, and then we're back to northwest winds again tomorrow. That should end up pushing the mercury into the 40s in Rapid City, 30s in Sioux Falls once again. And then from there, it's going to continue to moderate. And in fact, Wednesday and Thursday, we're getting pretty strong signals that the weather forecast will be much above normal. Closer look at the wind here. Today's wind out of the north, you can see those higher wind gusts in the 20-mile-an-hour range across the east. We'll settle the wind down late this afternoon. A quick turnaround, though, to the south overnight tonight. A steady breeze, probably 10 to 20. And then the wind goes back to the northwest. We're going to do that whole cycle in just 24 hours. So I guess, you know, in that regard, there are a few things we'll have to keep track of in the forecast. There are the numbers today, 18 Brookings, 18 in Marshall, 30 in Rapid City. Well, is there any chance that things can change before Christmas to give us a little snow? Well, I'll walk you through what we're thinking here in the Storm Center. That's next as we continue on Kettle Land This Morning.
There's always something new under the sun. CBS Mornings, weekdays on CBS.
Good morning, Kettle Land. It's now 18 minutes after the hour. We'll get to today's top business news in just a moment, but first. Senator Joe Manchin has all but delivered a death blow to President Joe Biden's $2 trillion domestic initiative. The West Virginia Democrat says he can't support the package, with his colleagues now desperate to salvage what's left. Congress has recessed, and that's for the holidays, but some lawmakers are demanding a vote, though that seems unlikely. Others are working on changes to hopefully win Manchin's support. Dr. Anthony Fauci says the Omicron variant of the coronavirus is raging around the world. Tomorrow, President Biden plans to give what his press secretary says is a stark warning of what the winter will look like for unvaccinated Americans. Chinese tennis star Peng Shuai has denied saying she was sexually assaulted, despite a November post accusing a former top Communist Party official of forcing her into sex. A Singapore media outlet posted video of Peng that was reportedly taken on Sunday, in which she says she's been staying home mainly in Beijing, but was free to come and go as she chose. Peng disappeared for several weeks following the accusations, leading many people to fear for her safety.
Turning to this morning's business news, jurors will begin their first full day of deliberations in the fraud case against former Theranos CEO Elizabeth Holmes. The jury has plenty of evidence to review after a three-month trial. That includes the testimony of 32 witnesses and more than 900 exhibits. The jury began their deliberations late on Friday and took the weekend off before resuming this morning. If convicted on all counts, Holmes could face up to 20 years in prison. YouTube TV began restoring access to Disney content after a dispute between companies led to an interruption of service. YouTube told viewers they were restoring service so customers could once again watch networks provided by Disney. That includes ESPN, FX, National Geographic, and local ABC stations. The outage stemmed from a breakdown in negotiations between YouTube and Disney over a contract. However, they reached an agreement on Sunday. While restaurants in the U.S. are open without restrictions, they are entering their second winter of the pandemic anxious about what's ahead. Restaurants are dealing with labor shortages, skyrocketing food costs, and the Omicron variant. In the UK, hundreds of corporate parties were canceled due to an increase in cases. Some restaurant owners in the U.S. fear restrictions will return if infections climb.
When we come back, Brian tells us just how high the temperatures will climb. Plus, it's a basketball highlight you won't want to miss. Coming up in this morning's What's Trending. That's on the way next.
Welcome back. The NBA may have a new star player.
During a timeout during the Clippers and Thunder game over the weekend, a little dog did a 360 dunk with a plush basketball into a toy basket.
The dunk proved to be good luck as the Thunder went on to beat the Clippers 104 to 103.
Move over, LeBron James.
Dog's got some good skills, so.
Hanging on the rim and then dropping it through very politely. But yeah.
Can your dog do anything like that?
Likes to chew on stuff. I don't know about a basketball or putting it in a hoop. Maybe that's next spring or next summer's project.
Working on that, yeah.
Start working on
that
the basketball
That could be your
skills.
Dog next.
Yes. Ryan, do your pets have any talents?
No, they like to tease each other a lot, but yeah, games and that kind of stuff. They liked being inside a little bit yesterday, though. A little chilly out there. I know as the winds picked up, at least I thought in the later part of the day, but you know, we still hit 36. And this time of year, you have to think of 30s as being at or above normal now. It's all that adjustment. But now today, definitely colder as we look at the jet stream. Here's the week. And, you know, we're at that time of the segment of the newscast. We're going to talk about the big picture. And so a little snow teases us tomorrow. See where it's at, though, on the maps? North Dakota, northern Minnesota. So that's going to zip through. Then we're going to see a replacement as mild air. Yep, it is definitely looking milder into at least Wednesday, Thursday, and then by Friday, well, Friday's weather map looks a little interesting. We've got a lot of cold air to the north. It's not exactly in any hurry to moving south. And what we see on the display here is this general wind flow. That's the jet stream moving in out of the Pacific Northwest. So we actually have a little mention of showers on Friday. Yeah, that'll be at least something there to entertain. I also think by the time we get into early next week, there's probably another piece of this very active Pacific Northwest pattern coming our direction. Now, so far, most of this is in agreement that we're not looking at any major storms here, okay? A lot of this is gonna sit in the Northwest and kind of sit there and brew and stir and kicking out a couple of systems, and then maybe by the middle part of next week, we can use the word cold or colder, as this would be an installment of that. We'll see how much of it lingers toward New Year's, but that's kind of the overall setup. Now, once it gets colder, then, of course, we can see if we can get more snow here, but a lot of that's going to happen after Christmas. It's not going to be before. Here now, the specifics. So let's take a look at this little system tomorrow. It involves a fast-moving low-pressure center. So already this scoots into the weather map, and it almost even scoots out by 7 in the morning. So this is mainly overnight snow in North Dakota. I'll phrase it as AM snow, and you can see by midday it's out. Then that's it. Wednesday looks milder into Thursday as well. Temperatures are above averages. We're looking at a batch of 50-degree weather, likely western South Dakota on Thursday. I think Sioux Falls probably will be somewhere in the middle 40s with a southerly wind, and you can already guess, yeah, those little brown patches in your yard, they're probably going to get bigger, I would expect, into this midweek forecast. And then to top it off, well, just before Santa gets here, it could rain a little. Now, that's something else we're going to have to just toss out there on that seven-day forecast as we evaluate our temperature trends. I always like to keep an eye on that because I never feel really comfortable forecasting rain showers in December and just say all rain, because it's probably not going to be just all rain, and so we'll see how that ends up coming out. But at this point, it doesn't look like any major amounts of precipitation. Let's wrap it up with your forecast, and there it is, that snow map through Christmas. I don't know. Do you want me to skip by that one? I know some of you want a white Christmas. Many of you do. So we'll hold on to what we've got. Temperatures today, Sioux Falls at 25, 23 in Mitchell. Here's your seven-day forecast, and those 40s are back by Thursday. We'll have more to come. Stay with us.
Come together this Christmas and celebrate with these congregations and special Christmas programming. Watch Christmas Eve services on Keloland TV with Celebrate Church, Bethany Mennonite Church, and Central Church. Christmas Day, watch Celebrate Church, Bethany Mennonite Church, and First United Methodist Church. Plus, watch A Prairie Christmas and Christmas at the Cathedral. Watch Christmas Eve and Christmas Day specials on Keloland TV.
What are you really giving when you give to the Sioux Empire United Way? Your donations create futures for youth, second chances for people in crisis, peace of mind for older adults. When you share the good, your gift affects one out of every three people in the Sioux Empire. We're better when we're united. See the good your donation does at seuw.org.
Good morning, Keloland. Forecast first today. Looks like temperatures into the 20s and teens. So definitely cool down for most of us. Sioux Falls at 25, Aberdeen 20s. Actually there at 17, but 20s in Pier and 30 degrees in Rapid City. What will the rest of the week bring? We'll talk details coming up in this half hour of Keloland This Morning.
Live from Keloland Media Group, Keloland This Morning.
How Jackrabbit fans are feeling this morning after SDSU's loss in the FCS semifinal game. Plus,
the biggest thing is to have it when you need it. You don't want to make the trip if it's not safe conditions, so to have a 50-pound bag sitting there is just kind of brings peace of mind.
Have you stocked up on ice melt for the winter? What to keep in mind before you buy a container? Coming up. Good morning and welcome to Kettle Land This Morning.
Thanks for waking up with us. It's a sad morning for Jackrabbit fans after the SDSU football team lost to Montana State in the FCS semifinal.
Fans turned out at Cubby's Sports Bar in Brookings Saturday to cheer on the team from home. They were still able to enjoy food and the company of other Jackrabbit fans, even though the final score wasn't what they were rooting for.
Brookings in general and South Dakota State, like, the support is kind of what makes this place great. And so this is kind of on display today with this place packed. You pretty much had to get a reservation to get a table.
Despite the loss, fans say they're still proud of the team for coming within one game of playing for a national championship.
This means U.S. Senator Mike Rounds lost a friendly wager with Montana's U.S. Senator Steve Daines. Rounds will have to wear a Montana State cap on the floor of the Senate and serve up some beef jerky from Montana. You can learn more about the bet and read some trash-talking tweets between the two senators by going to this story on our Capital News Bureau page at KettleLand.com.
We have a couple of road closures in Sioux Falls to tell you before you head to work and school this morning. The outside northbound lane of South Marion Road will be closed near the intersection of 14th Street. Crews will be building a new driveway approach. It should take a couple of days. Also this morning, the outside westbound lane of East 26th Street, along with the sidewalk of the north side of the street, will be closed between Veterans Parkway and South Highland Avenue. Crews will be doing utility work there for about 4 days.
Turning to weather, a chilly start to the week, but temps are expected to climb as we work our way towards Christmas, Brian.
Absolutely. Looking a little warmer here down the road as we watch your weather patterns this morning, though. A few flurries in the air as we begin with Kettle Land Live Doppler HD. A little bit of the snow falling from Aberdeen down to about Faith. I will really call it flurries. It's really kind of been a very minimal amount actually falling there, and it's kind of falling apart as we speak. Temperatures right now, 17 in Aberdeen. It's actually not terribly cold, but the wind is definitely feeling colder as we usher in a north breeze here, and that's creating wind chill values in the single digits above and below zero in the northern half of South Dakota, with a minus one now in Sisseton. And there's the wind out of the north, and the numbers sustained at 10 to 20. So overall today, we'll cut those highs over what we had yesterday, 25 Sioux Falls, 24 in Pierre, and 27 degrees in Phillip. Well, back to above normal weather, and we'll have details on that forecast coming up in just a few minutes.
Thank you, Brian. The 26th annual Heroes Behind the Badges blood drive starts in 1 week. You can donate blood in honor of Sioux Falls Fire Rescue or the Sioux Falls Police Department. The friendly competition goes from December 27th to January 7th. You can sign up to donate blood at either Sanford or Avera. The Bloodmobile will also host pop-up donation clinics around the city, including at Hy-Vee, Flyboy Donuts, and Shields. Check out the Community Blood Bank website to sign up. Law enforcement in Western Kettle Land is giving back to the community this holiday season. The Pennington County Sheriff's Office, Douglas Resource Officers, and officials from other agencies helped 20 families buy Christmas gifts. Deputies say the event was a fun experience.
Some students in the Sioux Falls School District are getting extra Christmas cheer delivered to them this week. Volunteers were busy this weekend wrapping gifts. The Promising Futures Fund of Sioux Falls received an anonymous donation of $10,000 to buy gifts for kids in need. That means 300 kids from Lowell, Hawthorne, and Terry Redland Elementary Schools will each get two presents.
So they're the schools with the highest rates of needs. So the kindergartners and first graders at these schools are going to give these gifts.
These gifts will be dropped off for students on Tuesday before they leave for holiday break. A Sioux Falls bank is also spreading a little holiday joy in the form of cash. For 12 straight days, Plains Commerce Bank is randomly hiding a $50 bill in different businesses around the city. The bank started hiding the money last Sunday and will continue until this Thursday as part of a social media scavenger hunt.
And then posting it on Facebook, kind of where, you know, the area of the business, and giving people little hints and clues on where they're at. And then when they find it, they get it. Very simple.
Carlson says the person who finds the money can use it however they like. He says this is also a way to help promote area businesses.
A nationwide program to honor those who paid the ultimate sacrifice for their country came to the new state's Veterans Cemetery in Sioux Falls Saturday. People bundled up and gathered to pay their respects as part of Wreaths Across America, where holiday wreaths were placed at each veteran's gravestone throughout the cemetery. The event also included a 21-gun salute to honor fallen members of the military.
And we thought it would be really fitting to also include the Wreaths Across America program here at the State Cemetery, just to bring it full circle. You know, we honor our veterans, we bring them out to D.C., but once they've gone on, we also want to continue honoring them as best we can and remember their service and sacrifices.
It was an incredible reminder of how much gratitude South Dakotans have for men and women who serve and who have served. Even when it's not comfortable, we're here because we want to be counted among the grateful.
The plan is to make Wreaths Across America an annual event at the State Veterans Cemetery.
When we come back, meteorologist Brian Carstens will have a look at this week's weather. But first, let's send it over to Tony DeCopel in New York to find out what's coming up on CBS.
Ahead on CBS Mornings, we talk to America's doctor about the Biden administration's plan to curb the fast-spreading Omicron variant and if we're headed for another lockdown. Don't say the word. Plus, Saturday Night Live executive producer and Kennedy Center honoree Lorne Michaels shows Gail how the comedy magic comes together. All that and more at 7.
Aloha! I'm Brittany Kay, inviting Kello Lamb viewers on a holiday vacations tour to the Hawaiian Islands March 12th through the 21st. Enjoy the tropical scenery on Oahu, the Big Island, and Maui. This tour offers the perfect balance between scheduled activities like visiting Volcanoes National Park, mixed with personal leisure time you can spend golfing or sitting on the beach. Visit holidayvacations.com, keyword Kello Land, for information on how you can attend a virtual travel show or call 888-557-1020 for a free brochure.
This message is sponsored by the Avera Tradition of Caring in Kello Land. Because of MB, women and families are empowered to live their best lives. Because of MB, women of all ages and stages can get help entering or re-entering the workforce. As far back as the Great Depression through today's challenges. Now more than ever, you can find transformation at work and in life. Because of MB. Get help or get involved at MB.org.
Welcome back to Kello Land this morning, starting off Christmas week forecast. And a few ups and downs, a few things here and there, but you know, overall, I'd say a fairly quiet weather week, which is good for travel. Will it be good for snowmaking at Great Bear? Well, maybe at times, but there are going to be days where, yeah, it's definitely going to be warmer. Although they're making progress, there's certainly that to see on our live cam this morning as temperatures today will be cooler, likely only in the middle 20s. Yesterday, though, we hit 36 Sioux Falls. We had 40-degree weather yesterday afternoon from Winter up to Pier. Even 50s emerged once again in Rapid City. And that's not going to be the, in fact, that's not the only time we're going to have that this week. We'll likely see more 50s developing by especially Thursday. It might even be Wednesday again in western Kello Land. Now, intermixed with this story, we have a few passing cold fronts. And so this morning, we got a little bit of snow in the air. Just enough to mention that from Aberdeen to about Faith this morning. Just a few flurries, really light stuff, not anything that we're going to put together an accumulation map on that. Temperatures are getting colder. We have 17 now in Aberdeen, and we'll just kind of hold the line today in the middle teens here across the northeast and even Sioux Falls area in the low 20s now. Feels like temperature, though, is 11 in Sioux Falls, and 4 degrees is what it feels like right now in Brookings. All right, let's have a look at the big picture. So on the pattern here, let's look at this. So we've got a north wind this morning that's keeping our temperatures down, or at least dropping a bit here as we conclude the early afternoon hours. I think right now, probably looking at those teens in the northeast. Tonight, we'll see a quick drop on the temperature, but then as the winds pick up out of the south, we're going to see temperatures likely to climb into the 30s in Sioux Falls. And I think that that snow chance in the morning will mainly be in North Dakota. And that one might be the last one, at least for this series. And then as we see those temperatures climbing on Wednesday and Thursday, we're probably going to end up losing some snow, not gaining it. Here's a sample just to show you where we see this forecast headed. The European model on Wednesday already is having 43 in Sioux Falls. So tells you where we may end up nudging our temperatures. How about that 50 in Rapid? Well, get used to more of that. Here's a look at Thursday. we could be looking at widespread 50-degree weather from Pier to Rapid City on Thursday. Sioux Falls easily in the 40s, and beyond that, into Christmas Eve. Well, the weather does change a little bit. Have a look at this map. We've got some cooling going on, but as we talk about that, we're talking about maybe some shower chances on Friday. A little early to say how that all comes together because, you know, with the chance of a little rain, we'll see where those temperatures end up going as we go toward the nighttime hours. But right now, it still looks above normal. Forecast today, 25 Sioux Falls, 25 in Winter, 30 in Rapid City, and that 7-day forecast. Well, as we peg these numbers, even into the weekend, there's Christmas Day, 39 in Sioux Falls, 32 in the area on Sunday. So by and large, it's a quiet week and above normal. We'll have the rest of the 7 days coming up as we continue on Kettle Land This Morning.
The exclusive sponsor of Kettle Land This Morning is SDN Communications, the region's most reliable network. Enjoy the uptime.
Welcome back. From shovels to snowblowers, there are all kinds of items you need to keep handy during the winter. Kettle Land's Ariana Schumacher joins us now with another item you need to keep in stock. Good morning, Ariana.
Good morning, Travis. With the unpredictable weather, you need to have supplies to clear the ice from your sidewalks and driveways. And there are lots of different ice melt products to help to choose from.
This time of year, it's not uncommon to find a patch of ice. And whether you have pets or plants, or are just looking to keep your concrete sidewalk in good shape, picking the right ice melt is a key factor.
There are differences between pet safe and there's organic kinds that are better for your plants in the spring that have less runoff, that cause less damage. There are kinds that are friendly for new concrete as well. So it just kind of depends on what the customer has going on in their yard and lifestyle.
You will also want to make sure you're applying it properly.
So we carry a couple different spreaders here in store. We've got walk behind and then kind of just handheld. Depending on your scenario, if you're on a corner lot, you may want to look into more of a walk behind, able to do it kind of all in one go and are not needing to constantly be refilling it. If you're in more of a smaller area, single stall garage, just a little bit of a sidewalk to cover, you may want to go with more of a hand spreader.
You want to make sure you have enough ice melt for when the weather hits.
This is South Dakota, so it's definitely going to differ from person to person and yard to yard, but I would go with the bigger bag. At this part of the season, we're just had like two snows so far, really. So we know there's more to come. There's more ice storms. There's more snow coming. Get the bigger bag. You're going to use it up by the end of the season.
Now, some good tips there. I'm not a fan of ice. I have a long ways to fall when I slip and fall, and I've done that a time or two.
Oh, so. For sure.
And. There are some right ways and wrong ways to go about this, right?
Yeah, for sure. When you're applying the ice melt, you want to make sure that you're kind of covering it in an even layer and not just dumping it all in one spot. When you do that, it will cause concrete damage.
All right. Thank you, Ariana.
Still to come on Kettle Land This Morning, we have the details of a fire that injured two firefighters and damaged a popular tourist destination. Plus, we look into the child care crisis happening across the country, including right here in South Dakota. Those headlines and more before you head out the door.
Jordan knows he shouldn't eat this entire bowl of nachos, but tonight he's earned that right. Because a few hours ago, in the middle of happy hour, he recognized a sign. Not from the gods or a bolt of lightning, but from a double heart, a kissy face, and a fourth ha in ha ha ha. That's when Jordan knew he was buzzed. So when it was time to go, he got a ride home instead of driving. Be a legend like Jordan. Recognize your buzzed warning signs and get a ride home. Buzz driving is drunk driving.
They're leaders, role models, and mentors.
Kettle Land Media Group wants to share stories of women making a difference.
Nominate a remarkable woman from your community at kettleland.com.
The deadline for nominations is December 31st. Get news, weather, and sports delivered to your inbox. Sign up on kettleland.com.
Good morning. morning, Kelloland. It's 10 minutes ahead of the hour. We'll get to today's top stories in just a moment. But first, let's send it over to meteorologist Brian Carsons for a check on your morning forecast. Good morning, Brian.
All right. Good morning as we begin Christmas week. Well, temperature's not too bad this morning at 23, but we're probably holding the line here with this colder air coming in. We're not going to get much warmer than that here as we head through the afternoon, and that's courtesy of a north wind. Let's have a look at the rest of the numbers here on the maps this morning and also a little bit on radar, a few flurries. You know, they're definitely festive flurries now. The returns on radar seem to be reducing here as each scan of the radar passes through. A little north breeze to go with it here, 10 to 20 miles per hour. And that wind, bringing in the colder temperatures, as you see around Buffalo at 10 now in the northwest. And I think Sioux Falls will probably slip a few more degrees and then try to bounce back in the low 20s this afternoon. What does it feel like out there? Well, 2 degrees is the wind chill factor now in Rapid City. You know, if you think about it, the high yesterday was 53. So, you know, you kind of go back and forth in this type of weather pattern, and we'll see more of those fluctuations to come this week. 23 in Mitchell today, 18 degrees Brookings, partly cloudy. That's weather for now, and we'll have a recap on your 7 days in a few minutes.
Thank you, Brian. Two firefighters were hurt during a weekend fire at a popular destination in Custer State Park.
The Custer Volunteer Fire Department says crews were called to the Sylvan Lake Lodge just before 7 Saturday night. Firefighters say flames were coming from the hotel, extending to the roof and outside the building. Crews from multiple agencies across two states helped battle the fire. Freezing temperatures along with snow and ice covered the roads and made firefighting efforts difficult. The cause of the fire is under investigation.
New this morning, a Texas man is facing multiple charges after a crash northeast of T. The Lincoln County Sheriff's Office says the crash happened in the area of 271st Street and Kerrs Lake Place just before 8 a.m. Sunday. Investigators say an SUV crossed the center line and struck a pickup. The 38-year-old driver of the SUV was arrested for DUI and abuse or cruelty to a minor.
Closing arguments will start today in the manslaughter trial of the former Minnesota police officer who shot and killed Dante Wright. Kim Potter says she meant to use her taser instead of her gun while she killed Wright as he tried to drive away from a traffic stop. The case will go to the jury after the judge gives final instructions. The judge says she won't make jurors deliberate on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. They'll return after the holiday if they haven't reached a verdict by then.
The 2022 legislative session hasn't even started yet, but a bill proposed by Governor Kristi Noem is already receiving attention. The draft bill is titled Protecting Fairness in Women's Sports. It's similar to one that was debated during the 2021 legislative session. As part of the proposal, only athletes listed as female on their birth certificate can participate in women's sports. It would impact athletes from kindergarten through college.
In our bill last year, it was a statement. You had to make a statement every year that identified whether you were male or female, and now we're using the birth certificate.
Opponents say this bill would exclude transgender kids from being part of a team on which they are comfortable. The 2022 legislative session starts on January 11th. You can read the full draft bill by clicking on this story on Kelloland.com.
The city of Sioux Falls, the state of South Dakota, and the entire United States are facing a child care crisis right now. That crisis can have a major impact on the economy. In tonight's Eye on Kelloland, Lauren Solick will look at what is causing the crisis and how it's impacting Sioux Falls.
It seems like a never-ending circle for child care right now. Centers can't find the staff, so they raise wages to entice new employees. That, in turn, leads to an increase of rates at the centers.
As rates increase, parents find it more difficult to afford childcare, forcing them to decide on whether or not they should just stay home from work. And if they do opt for that, then less employees are in the workforce. According to a recent study from Augustana, the average cost of childcare in Sioux Falls is almost $10,000 a year for one child. That number is most going to grow.
And most providers are looking to increase their rates the beginning of the year. So for infant care, a lot of them are well over $200 a week.
In tonight's Eye on Kelloland, I'll talk with experts in the child care field, as well as a mom experiencing the crisis firsthand to get a better understanding of the current challenges.
Thank you, Lauren. A South Dakota Newswatch article also digs into the child care crisis across the state. Seven South Dakota counties have no state registered daycare providers, and several have only one or two at-home providers. Overall, in South Dakota, there are about 73,000 children under age six, but only about 34,000 child care slots. You can read the South Dakota Newswatch report right now on Killaland.com.
New this morning, Moderna says its booster increased antibodies 37 times greater than pre-boost levels for fighting Omicron. It comes as health officials warn that the number of new cases could reach a million a day. Federal health officials don't know if the new strain causes more serious illness, but they say it's clearly more contagious. Senators Elizabeth Warren and Cory Booker say they've tested positive for COVID-19. Experts say even fully vaccinated people should wear masks at all times inside airports, train stations, and other public spaces. Israel has announced a travel ban to the United States, Canada, and eight other countries amid the spread of the Omicron variant. The U.S. joins a growing list of European countries and other destinations that Israel are barred from traveling to. A parliamentary committee is expected to give the final approval of the measure. Once authorized, the travel ban will take effect on Wednesday.
New rules start today when it comes to collecting garbage in Sioux Falls. Under a new ordinance, you can choose between curbside pickup or valet services. The new rule also says garbage cans must be stored inside a building or somewhere out of sight. And they can be pulled to the curb after 12 p.m. the day before and have to be returned to the building by 11 p.m. the day after. If you have questions on the new ordinance, you are asked to contact your garbage hauler.
The annual Michael J. Entringer Scholarship Classic helps raise money to fund college scholarships for high school seniors. When the classic started in 1994, $500 was split into two scholarships. Now, $1,000 scholarships are given to dozens of high school seniors each year. Organizers are set to hit the $1 million mark this school year for the total amount of money given out through the scholarships. The event is named after Mike Entringer, who died unexpectedly in 1990.
You know, I ref with Mike from the very beginning. We ref for 13 years together. And, you know, and to see the people that have jumped behind it to help out. Yeah, it means a lot. You know, some days it brings tears to my eyes because, you know, people involved, you know, with it and are gung-ho to help do it.
The Boys Entringer Classic will be on December 31st at Brookings High School. Warm inside the gym and not too bad outside this week, Brian.
Yeah, I'd say overall a fairly mild week. Today, though, a little cooler, 25 Sioux Falls for high, Aberdeen 17, Pier at 24, partly cloudy, Rapid City around 30. That's definitely cooler than yesterday. Let's look at tonight. Lows dropping back into the teens, a steady south wind overnight. Even Aberdeen is down to 8 above zero. Well, snow cover. Here's how it looks. Yep, if you're hoping for a white Christmas, it's going to be a battle just to hold on to what we've got. And, yeah, that technically, I guess, in Sioux Falls is above an inch of snow. But, yeah, as you're going to see in our extended forecast, it's going to start melting again. Here's a look at today. We see dry skies for the vast majority as passing flurries exit. And, again, it'll be a little chilly tonight, but most of the snow tomorrow will be to our north. And with a minute to go, let's recap your 7-day forecast. Look at Wednesday, close to 40. Thursday, mid 40s. A chance of a shower, maybe. Friday, we'll keep an eye on that, in the upper 30s. And then Christmas Day itself, 39 degrees. Yep, it looks like a fairly mild Christmas at this point. Aberdeen also, milder temperatures down the road, 40 by Thursday. Christmas Eve could feature a little bit of precipitation, but as we talked about during the newscast this morning, more favorable that it would be rain versus snow, but we'll have to take another look at that again later today. How about 50s for Pier and Rapid City? Looks very likely we'll see 50s in Rapid City as early as Wednesday. Thanks.
Thank you, Brian. That's our time. Thanks for watching.
Have a great day.
Welcome to CBS Mornings on this Monday, the last one before Christmas. I'm Gail King.
I'm Tony DeCoppo.
And I'm Nate Burleson.
Yes, he is. We're all here. Let's go to today's eye opener. It's your world in 90 seconds.
COVID-19 cases, hospitalizations, and deaths are rising again throughout the country.
We need to act urgently.
If you want to be optimally protected, get boosted.
COVID cases surge right before the holidays. Why this could be different than past waves.
Two Democratic senators have tested positive for coronavirus. Elizabeth Warren of Massachusetts and Cory Booker of New Jersey.
A single Democrat stops the president's agenda, at least for now. What's next for Build Back Better?
I cannot vote to continue with this piece of legislation.
Plus, a look inside North Korea, 10 years after Kim Jong-un took power of the nuclear-armed nation.
How solid is Kim Jong-un's grip on power?
He has absolute power.
Sudan's health ministry says more than 100 people have been injured in demonstrations against October's coup.
The Jacksonville Jaguars driving into the red zone. There is a fan on the field taking a moment to celebrate before he gets tackled.
Championship point. Hilly to Redke.
The Wisconsin women taking home a national championship.
It is the first ever volleyball championship for the program.
Oh, my God.
Tiger Woods says his first time competing on a golf course since his car crash in February was a blast.
Beautiful stroke.
Woods and his 12-year-old son, Charlie, finished second at the PNC Championship by two strokes to John Daly and his 18-year-old son.
To have this opportunity to be able to play with my son and to have these memories for a lifetime, it's worth all the pain.
This morning's eye opener is presented by Progressive, making it easy to bundle insurance.
Welcome to CBS Mornings. Say it with me. I've got a lot of people who normally don't even watch golf,
right,
like me, were watching yesterday just to see the two of them together.
It is
awesome.
Heartwarming, and Charlie can play. I tell you what.
I know them sponsors are tripping all over themselves to get to that future. Young man.
Yes.
Got a bright future. We got a bright show for you today as we all try to stay COVID-free. We got a lot to cover, including a conflict that could affect hundreds of thousands of travelers in the new year. Airlines are rolling out saying that as the rollout of high-speed cell service happens, it could become actually less safe to fly. Wireless carriers, meanwhile, are saying, that's not true. Chris Van Cleve is going to dig into it and tell us what's really going on.
That's really troubling. Plus, we're going to talk to newly minted Kennedy Center honoree, Lorne Michaels.
When I think of some of the biggest names in comedy over the past 40 years, I'm just like, wow, I can't believe Lorne fired all of them.
That's a little preview there of Colin Jost.